That's weird. Audio just cut out. And then just came back.
Enough fury. Pandemonium is a harsh realm. And its inhabitants must be resourceful to survive, but none more so than the scavengers who armor themselves in the very rocks beneath their feet. They may appear as mighty giants to their foes, but a few hard strikes will reveal that their true form is much smaller. That the barbed lurker is part demon, for its appearance has an aspect far too sinister to occur naturally. It expels a noxious poison worthy of the hells, and from what I can tell, it will only feed on its own kind or the corpses of demons. One hopes it will never encounter a human. Hazards of Pandemonium lie above ground. The tunnelers roam just beneath the surface, breaking through to snatch prey in their enormous jaws. And my heroic friends ask why I wish to stay inside the fortress.
Well, never mind. What? That's gross.
voice.
I still do not hear anything.
So he talks.
He's calling me.
Not all.
Pulling me somewhere.
Not all. Threats in pandemonium lie above ground. The wicked tunnel. He goes on. He's like, and my friends ask me why I always want to stay indoors when I visit this realm.
Nephilim! We found something we can use! Long ago, this weapon was used to bring down a mighty siege beast and its demon master. Even now, the device maintains its power. Sadly, the weapon now attacks us as well as our enemies. We can use it in this fight, though, if we can regain control of it.
Stink.
Yes.
unfortunate that Kurakos corrupted the weapon. It is useless to us now. At least it cannot do any more damage. Weapon was created in response to a siege on the Pandemonium Fortress by Kurakos, a demon lord who rode a monstrous siege beast. At great cost to ourselves, we channeled much energy into the great weapon and succeeded in bringing down Kurakos and his mount. Upon his death, the demon was drawn inexplicably into the weapon, and it has been attacking us ever since.
I need fury.
Thank you.
I must wait longer. I am badly hurt. I must wait longer. More fury. Fury. Heal. Not enough fury. Returns.
Yeah.
Stand before me!
don't think you have defense.
Is there anything about the past you would like to know?
What were the barbarians like in your time?
Secretive. They mostly kept to the mountain, coming down only every few seasons to raid the neighboring lands. But they were fearsome warriors even then. You would have fit in just fine.
Outskirts of Pandemonium, a lumbering giant with a gaping hollow at its core. Somehow, it can hide its body away, disguising itself as a mere portal. Those who pass through it are trapped in a distant world, never to be seen again.
I have found many references to the beasts of Pandemonium in Kane's old writings. He journeyed there 20 years ago to help a band of heroes seal away the primevals, and his discoveries appear to have shaken him deeply. Sometimes he would stare outside the fortress walls, and winged beasts would appear, calling his name.
Thank you. Your flesh is weak.
Make a fine team.
For me. Thank you.
my friend.
I don't know how to use that.
I wonder what lies beneath this.
I wish I could do that.
Ah!
resistance against my blows.
Is not so different from my own. There is still pain, suffering, hatred, and death. I could sleep another 1,000 years and I would find the world much the same.
Not if we fail.
Smile on me.
My pack is full. I need to go back.
Pandemonium is the Alpha and the Omega of the Eternal Conflict. It lies at the center of all things, linking the realms of Heaven and Hell. Long ago, when the angels were young, the aspect of wisdom found the Eye of Anu here. He named it the World Stone, and all of Heaven swore to protect it.
Something now inhabits the fortress. I am certain of it. Long have I gazed upon its scarred facade, dreaming of the safe haven its walls offer. But it has changed. The vacant terraces have turned cold. I am so desperate to escape the demons. But whatever is in the fortress may be worse.
More fury. I need fury. Not enough fury.
need your aid. The servant of a demon lord is attempting to revive its master. It must be stopped.
More fury.
There it is. Let us drive it back to hell. Angel Nephilim.
I know that the Prophet would have sided against Malthael. He always saw the potential in us. He believed that we could achieve something the Seraphim could not. How sad he would be to witness this. Magnificent.
Not enough fury. I need fury.
Thank you. running up at me.
The ram is here, but I must finish collecting the siege runes first.
I wish I could do that.
Mm-hmm.
recharging.
I am badly hurt. I have been hit. More fury. Healed.
Strange magic radiates from these foes.
I have been hit.
Guide my hand!
I am badly hurt.
I wish I could do that.
I need fury.
I have been hit.
I wish I could do that.
Healed.
Sometimes it seems you think only of the past.
Nonsense! I think often about what the future may hold. Adventures lie before us. The past is so distant, and the future such a mystery.
The Sliver has revealed Malfail's plan to me, and it is worse than I could have imagined. He means to use the Black Soul Stone to capture all demonic essences, even those that linger in human hearts. If the stone is altered to rip the demonic essence out of every man, woman, and child on Sanctuary, they will all die.
We can still stop him. We need to attack the fortress.
Malfail is fundamentally altering the Black Soul Stone. It will now pull in all the demonic essence from whatever plane of existence it finds itself in. But mankind is born of angel and demon alike. Every mortal, save myself, has demonic essence as an intrinsic part of their being. Losing that will rip their body and soul apart.
I spoke with the necromancer, Zael. He said that the source of my visions is not necromancy, but something else. Mm-hmm. He seemed unnerved by it.
I don't see anybody else.
When this is over, Tyriel will need to replace those who fell in the Tomb of Rakkas, and he'll continue to train and expand the Order of Nuhoradrim. With everything I've been through at your side, I think I can contribute to that effort.
Sleepy kid.
You built the Pandemonium Fortress.
Not on my own, but it was my idea. Yes. The angels raised it around the Worldstone many eons ago.
Then you must know a way in.
I fear not. The fortress is always changing. Caught between the forces of heaven and hell.
Malfeo was one of your brethren. Why did you not search for him when he left the heavens?
Malfeo kept to himself much of the time, and he was known to leave without warning. Eventually, the council became concerned. We sent his closest followers to find him. Most of them did not return.
Urzael, the maidens, they found Malfeo here. And continued to serve him.
It seems so. I never thought I would return here. Pandemonium was our battlefield for ages on end. Demons' blood saturated this ground. Many angels died defending it.
Why fight for this place?
Our battles revolved around the Worldstone. I had the Pandemonium Fortress built in order to protect it. Shatter the hook!
those hooks! Shatter the hooks! One last strike.
It is done.
Pandemonium Fortress. When I fought Malthael, my sword passed through him like air. He is in a state of death and life, impervious to physical harm. Your strength is not enough. To defeat him, you must channel the power of death as he does.
Look at the spirits gathered below. Could they be the key?
The power of the dead. If you could become one with it, you would be as Malthael is. And you could face him. But you must find a way, quickly. Every moment, thousands die, and Malthael's power grows beyond anything I have ever seen.